Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple sheet metal part in SOLIDWORKS with the help of hamming tool. We will learn how to use hamming tool here and create this hamming in sheet metal, SOLIDWORKS sheet metal. I hope you like it. So let's start to create this one. We have 2D drawing for this, so we will create with the help of this 2D drawing. So let's see. Now I'll go to file, new, and choose here part. Click OK. Now we are in the SOLIDWORKS interface. Here we can change background, so I'll always keep plain white. Now it's time to create a simple sheet metal part, and especially we are going to see hamming. This is our 2D file. So first let's make this upper part 24, 11, 8 millimeter. Okay, so let's start to create this simple part. Choose top plane sketch. Now here we are going to make base part. So first let me choose your line. Okay, start with origin point, go upward, then draw a tapered. Then many people ask me how to convert line into arc. So simply move your cursor somewhere and then again go back to this point and see, it will automatically convert to arc. No need to click any line or anything. Again draw line and click this line. Now let me choose horizontal. Now select these two lines. These two lines equal relation. In your left hand side you will see add relations, so this choose here equal relation. Okay, now center line, find out here center point. See, if you move your cursor you will find center point. Click from here to the center circle, click this one, horizontal relation. Again we need to create some more relation. Select these three lines and make relation symmetric. Okay, now let's define 24 millimeter 11 millimeter, and this one according to drawing 8 millimeter radius. Okay, now the distance from here to here, it's 21 millimeter. See, this distance is 21 millimeter. Now just go to sheet metal or right click here and click sheet metal and choose your flange base, base flange. See, its thickness going downward direction, so click here reverse direction, so let it come upward. K factor it is using for the bending allowance calculation, so 0.5 it is standard, so we will keep as it is. Okay, choose this one, edit appearance, and let's make little dark color so that we will identify. Okay, that's it. Now it's time to make this flange. This flange length is here, you will see 21, and corner radius 2 millimeter. So I'll choose your edge flange and I'll select the bottom line and drag your mouse upward. Now see, now here use default radius 2 millimeter. See, corner radius it's become big, we need 2 millimeter, 90 degree, and the bending length, see this blind, it shows bending length. So how much length? 21 millimeter. See, and here you have to choose this two very important thing, outer virtual shaft. If you are going to take dimension, it will took the dimension from this edge, this blue edge you are showing, because that's why we are going to take outer virtual shaft. And flange position material keep inside. Now see, if you choose material outside, see it's come outside. If you will choose at the bending edge, see it will comes totally outside. So we will always keep according to drawing, we need to keep inside. Okay. Now the very important part, hemming. How to do hemming in sheet metal? So let me choose here directly, or better to make some more things here, sketch. Now let's cut this one, 7.4, 4.6, let's cut this one. Choose circle and you will see here center of this circle. If you will move your cursor here, you will find center point. Let's draw two circles and you will see here previous center line. A smart dimension. First define the gap. According to drawing, it's 5.16 diameter. 7.14, 4.76 millimeter. Let me choose line and connect. Connect from here to this circle. Escape. Again choose from here to this circle. Escape. Now we need to remove this unnecessary things. So choose trim entity. Click here power trim. Just move, press your left key and move. Move your cursor and see it's trimmed. Okay. Now simply go to sheet metal and click here. You will find extruded cut command. The very important thing, you can simply select here link to thickness so that it will cut only up to the thickness of material. Otherwise no need, you can directly choose whatever you like length. See, but this one I prefer better. Okay, that's it. Now let's see hemming. Hem tool. First you have to choose edge from where you want to make bend. So any edge you can choose, no problem. Now here material inside or outside. If we will keep material inside because our thickness is 21 millimeter. If we keep outside, see, it's going outside above the bending line. So I'll choose inside above the below the bending line. And the type of size, closed. If we choose closed, see, is totally almost closed. This is open. It will give you gap. According to drawing, its length 4 millimeter and 0.5. It is the gap between these two sheet. And this one is comes for round. See, it comes round. It more round. So we need this one. Click OK. Even here one more option, edit hem width. Now what you can do here, simply select this point and move. Click finish. Now see, it makes hemming only up to this point. Click edit. Edit hemming. Now again you can move this up to this point. Finish. See, it completed. So this is the hemming tool, a very important tool in sheet metal, because hemming tool always used in sheet metal parts just to avoid the sharp edges. Let me choose this face, sketch, normal. Now here this cutout we need to make. This cutout 10 by 12, 6 millimeter from bottom and 2 millimeter radius. I'll choose first center line and you'll find a center point here. Draw a line up to here. Now choose center rectangle and choose this line as a center point and draw one rectangle. Smart dimension 12 millimeter, outside 10 millimeter, and the distance from bottom edge 6 millimeter. Okay, now let me choose here sketch fillet, radius 2 millimeter, and select whole rectangle. It will automatically select all the edges, corner edges. Okay, that's it. Click here, okay. Now just go to sheet metal, select extruded cut. Click here link to thickness so that it will cut only thickness. Okay. Oh, that's fine. So this is how we created our simple 3D sheet metal part with the help of hemming tool or hem tool. You can choose flatten. Now if you want to convert it, you can convert this drawing also into, or even you can directly save as, you'll choose your DXF. Why we choose DXF? Because in CNC machines, DXF file going to be used for programming purpose. Save. It will ask you sheet metal and here check geometry. Okay. Now let's see. It's going to save. Now see, this is our 2D drawing. Now let's save in any where you like to. So this is how we created our simple sheet metal part in SolidWorks with the help of hemming tool. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.